We've got a beautiful looking forecast for the day ahead. With weather like this, though, nice and warm outside, cool breeze by the water, all this blue sky and sunshine, even as the fog's burning back towards the coast. It's hard to believe we've ever had a bad seafare day when it comes to weather, but we have. Mother Nature has thrown us a wingdinger or two. Let's go ahead and take a look at some of the ones that we've experienced in the past.
Race day in Seattle dawned with a threat of rain.
Seafair Sunday, 1973, and a torrential downpour.
By race time, the skies had opened the floodgates. The crowd dwindled to about a third of its original size.
For the fans who stayed, it paid off with a historic battle between the Pay and Pack and the Miss Budweiser, if only they could have seen it through the fog and rain.
Well, we're getting set for racing mode here on the shores of Lake Washington. But I'll tell you, there's a lot of folks just trying to keep dry right now.
It was a similar story in 1995. Even our own Cairo 7 broadcast crew couldn't stay dry.
Here at the 11,000-foot level on Mount Rainier, it's getting a little drippy up here.
Oh, my.
It was. I remember the warmest I was that day was when a cup of hot coffee fell in my lap. That's what I remember about that entire day. But it's going to be nicer today.
And it's going to be more than localized warming, Steve.
Yes.
It's going to be warm across the board. Those temperatures, boy, they're heating up already. If we look at temperatures across Western Washington right now, you can see we've got 72 in Bremerton, just 63 right now for Olympia, but a warmer 66 for Bellingham. Now, as we move on from the current temperatures to the current wind speeds, a lot of folks on the water watching this, we've been having calm winds for the most part. They've been variable up to about 5 miles an hour, but later this afternoon they're going to be shifting to northerly and they're going to be picking up as well. So this morning's forecast will continue with mostly sunny skies and we're going to creep up into the low to mid 70s. By this afternoon, temperatures will be soaring into the upper 80s to low 90s. We've got a very warm day. I'd venture to almost call it hot, but we experienced 103 last week, so I won't quite call that hot yet. So today, 91 for Seattle, 93 for Olympia, 70 in Port Angeles, and 83 in Everett. It is great weather to get out and watch the Blue Angels. We've got blue skies out here. We're going to have that high show. The northerly winds, they'll be about 10 to 15 in the afternoon. So we can expect also, if you miss the Blue Angels, but you want to get out here for the hydroplanes, near the water, got a nice little sea breeze going, and it's going to feel much, much better if you're here watching the races. Expect your temperatures to start out again in the mid-70s and then creep into low 90s by the end of the day. So good-looking days ahead. Incidentally, in 1972, we did have a 91-degree seafare forecast. Or
okay.
Actually, we hit 91 on a Sunday.
We've been here before then.
We have. In fact, we've got several temperatures to show you here, in case you're wondering. Some of the historical highs for seafare. We've got, over the last 25 years, we've seen only 8 seafare Sundays in the 80s. The coolest high we had was back in 2002 at 66 degrees. But in the last 25 years, the highest was, or should say the warmest, was 87. Last year, we were 73. This year, working towards 91.
What a difference.
Oh, yeah. What a difference.
All right, thanks, Rebecca. You'll be back throughout the day with weather updates, right?
Yes.
Okay.
We'll see you then.